Hi and welcome to another one of the Tech Geeks videos. This deep dive, we get a lot of questions asked about what are dry and active contacts when we talk about Ubiquiti Access products and how do they actually work? What about wiring the door access, the door exit button or some other sensors? And can I actually make this work with a door or a garage opener that I've currently got? So we'll try and answer some of those questions. It is going to be a bit rough and ready, but hopefully gives you some of the things that I look at and see how this goes through. So we're going to be doing this just very simply with a Hub Mini. I'm just going to work through most of this on the bench and on my mobile phone because it will probably be a little bit easier. I've got a PoE injector here to our device over here. This is only a PoE Plus. It might moan, but this device is only going to be powering these locks, so PoE Plus is going to be ample for what it needs to be. Now out of the box here, you can see probably just about in the light, this is actually sent as dry. All right, and I just want to show you out of the box what happens. So if we look on my phone here, all right, I've got the mini hub adopted. If I just click on unlock, I get a very quiet tick or sound to show that I've unlocked it. All right, if I now actually connect this up to the terminals, so in this instance, we've got N and NC. NC means normally closed, NO means normally open. And this is basically how we wire these through. So we're gonna have a contact, doesn't really matter which way around we have it in here. Mine is normally set to open. So it means that if the circuit is open, no power is being provided to it. If my door strike is the opposite way around, then we plug into NC over here, meaning it's normally closed, and when the circuit is opened, then it will unlock. So having a look here, if I now tick for unlock, I don't have anything happen here. Why? And that's expected, because in dry, we're not actually providing any power into this device at all. All we're doing is we're actually just completing a circuit to allow another controller to actually be able to provide power. So if I just switch this over now to 12 volt and I do the same on my phone, unlock, you'll actually see now that the lock has unlocked for a few seconds. Now it's locked back up again. Do that again and it's available. So in active, we're actually sending power to our device, and most people's gate openers or garage door openers, they've already got power and everything set up. So they don't actually need to receive power, which is why we generally use it with dry contacts. So let's just have a look at the couple of other options that we've got on here. We'll leave this inactive at the moment. We've got a door opener. This is the UA button. Really simple. We're going to follow the same thing over here. We've got our exit terminals. These are dry contacts, so they're not actually providing any power. There we go. I've just pulled that one out because my fingers are having a little bit of a problem with it. Let me just do this again over here. All right, let me just check that, yep, that's still working. So I'm just going to put my minus in there and my plus in here. And you'll find that in your app, you have an option for how the terminals are set up. So if we go into settings here in Terminal Manager, my exit button, what do I want it to be? Close is active, so normally open. So at the moment, if I'm using my UA button, this circuit is normally open. When I push the button, it's going to complete the circuit. So I push the button and my door opener works. So if I had a circuit the opposite way around, which was normally closed and pushing the button opened it, then I could change that there over in my app to be the opposite way around. So now I've changed that to be the opposite way around. Let me just apply that and you'll actually find that this will stay unlocked permanently. And if I was to push the button, I would actually be now sending a lock command to it. So that's what that option actually does in here. So I'm going to put that back to normally open, and that will now leave this locked. And if I've got my exit button, I'm going to push it. That's how we now exit. So that's sort of adding a few of the options together, still inactive. But remember, the only bit that's active is my door lock in here. The buttons are all, if you like, passive. So what have I got over here? Let me just try and see if I can move. Which way can I move this? I can move it this way. Here we go. So over here, I've basically got what I might put on my garage door. So this might be on the floor of the garage door, and this might travel with the door lock. Again, this is a terminal. If we have a look on our phone over here, we would actually see if this circuit is completed. And it doesn't do anything about automatically opening the door or telling you whether the door is open. This is more about actually having an alert or showing you what the state it believes that it's in. So I've got an option here of either my door lock is normally in the open if it's closed, if the circuit is closed, or if the circuit is open. And I'm not actually sure which way this one. So the roller shutter would have come down. And then when the roller shutter is actually down, it will actually show me in the terminal block. It doesn't always update, but in the terminal block here, it would show me that this is complete. Let me just check that I've just pushed those far enough in. All right, so probably not that I can show you properly in here. Let me just check that it's not the other way around and normally open. But essentially, it doesn't do anything specifically with this. It's not going to alert you or show you what's going on. You can see at the moment this way round is telling me that it believes that it would be probably open at that point in time. I think I probably haven't got the rest of this actually set up, but it gives you an idea what you can do in this terminal. So you may have to have something that actually has power supplied to it. But potentially, if we were to do this round and show you what it can do, if you like, we could put this round this way over here and actually use this, if you like, as our door exit. You can see that that is open, and then put that on there, and theoretically after a few seconds it would note that it was closed. So we do have some options in there. If I took change the door position back to, I think, normally closed, let's see if that applies this back this way. Now the door is locked. As this comes down, it's actually unlocked it. So you can see it's actually doing anything, but it's not an exit option. It's not an automatically telling you that the door is open. It will only actually show up here in your terminal indicators that the door position is there and in the software, and you can maybe use that for a little bit more alerting. So let's just go back and switch this back to dry contacts. In dry contacts, remember, when I go back and hit unlock here, doesn't actually do anything and make anything work. So this is how we're going to set it for our garage door opener. I'm not going to put these, but as you can see, these will work in the dry contacts option the same as the door exit. Really, the door open position one is more just to tell you where it believes it's at. It doesn't actually really have a specific function unless you do that with some of your opening or closing options with your electric side of things. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to now take this and put this in place and show you a little bit about the garage opener, and should actually sort of show you how we're going to make this work with the scenario that we've got, again, using dry terminals, because we're not going to send 12 volts to it. So let's head into the garage and we can have a look how it all works over there. Okay, so this is a really old, like 15-year-old Merlin door opener. And please, you do want to have a look at your wiring diagrams or any more information on this. Please make sure you know what you're doing. Although we're working at 12 volts, it is your responsibility to work out what is in place. So I've got a number of terminals on the back here. I have a retrofitted door fob because my other one broke. And as we can see here, this is connected up to this terminal set here. And the negative and positive, and this is giving it 12 volt power to actually work. I've just put up here an Ethernet cable and my UA-Hub-Mini just to show us how it all works there. This, as you can see, is in the dry contact setting. That's because obviously this has already got power, and we're just sending a close, we're just closing a circuit, and when we close the circuit, that is actually causing the door to open or close. We're not doing anything more complicated than that, all right? This is just literally sending that signal. So it's super important that the actual device knows when to stop the door and have any other sensors. The door hub here has no functions for that. It's not gonna run this door up for a certain period of time. It will stop at a certain, it will just send a open, as far as it's concerned, it will just send a signal to close the circuit that's here. It won't do anything about how long. It doesn't know whether the door's open or closed. It is just sending a signal to do it. So this is really simple. I just want to show you in very basic terms, although this is wired here, I want to show you basically how these pieces fit together. So a very simple test for me for dry contacts, because I looked at the diagrams, were that basically all I need to do is complete the circuit between these two terminals. If I complete the circuit, so I can do that, remember, there's no, it should be no sparks or anything. If there's sparks, you've probably got something a little bit wrong. There's no voltage being applied. This is just completing a circuit. So if I actually complete between these two terminals, right, the door opener starts. If I do it again, it stops. If I do it again, it reverses its direction. That is a simple, that's all that we're going to get our UA Hub Mini up here to actually do, is that function. What we could do, obviously, is we could connect an exit switch to these terminals that I showed you before. Maybe you could put that on the wall of your garage so that you didn't need to actually set the controller going in the app, and you could just use that to set the garage to open. So in a moment, I'm going to just switch over to my phone and send the command to unlock the door so you can see what that actually does and works. And this will obviously work on a gate as well. All we're doing is we're relying on the functions of this, and we're just completing a dry circuit that says send or complete the circuit, at which point the controller does everything it needs to do. It knows how long to run for and how when to stop. All we're doing is essentially sending some change, a signal to say we've completed the circuit. Now, you can change how long that is open for. Maybe you're going to want to drop that to 1 second, because maybe if you hit the open button and realize the car's still there, you want to be able to hit the button again to lock the garage or stop the door moving. So let's just quickly jump on the phone and I'll actually show you this in action. So I've hopped back onto the phone and I've actually got this one here in place called the garage hub. It thinks there's an unauthorized opening. So you can see that there is a warning on there. And that's because basically I had two terminals joined together. I had my opening button that we saw that I was using, that garage opener earlier on the bench, to indicate when the door is open. It doesn't show me that the door is open. It just says there was unauthorized opening. We can maybe see that in some of the logs. So I could log in here and it suggested it might be open, but there isn't anything to tell me it is. So that you need a third party device to show you. So if I do now send my unlock command, actually the garage door now starts to open. If I send my unlock command again, I can actually stop the garage door from working. Now, in this instance, my timing between these is probably too long. So if we have a look at the lock, it says 5 seconds. I really need to drop this to 1 second so that it will sense me pushing the button in an emergency or I've got something slightly wrong. So let's tap this now. All right, and I should now be able to tap it again and it's reversed the cycle. If I tap it, I'm now closing the door only because I'm in the garage and I can see what's actually happening here. But if I stop it, it's actually stopped the door from working.
So I had a little bit of a chance to actually physically put all of these pieces in place and thought I'd show you how I've fitted it all together and how it's now actually working.
The PoE coming out here, this USW Flex 5, coming out, giving PoE in at the top here. On this side, I've got my exit button connected. Over on this side here, I have got, if you hopefully can maybe see that, over on this side here, I've got my door position sensor, which has been added to the bottom of the garage door. And this is my door opener cable. This is obviously rough and ready. It's a proof of concept, show that it actually can work. And that's how those bits are fitted there.
Then basically got a bit of 12 volt cable coming from the switch right over the top there, as you can see down this pipe here to where I have put a, this is a UA button, but you could have put anything else that you'd wanted to here that completes the circuit. If I push the button, as you can hear, the garage door there starts to open. If I push it again, it stops. Push it again, it reverses. So that's my manual override, if you like.
Just down here, I've put in a door position sensor, and this should therefore be able to show in the app when the door has been opened.
Then basically I've got some more 12 volt cable that comes across here, down. If you remember, we looked at these terminals. This just feeds my normal key fob up the top here. And all I was interested in is these two, which just completes the circuit. Remember, I've had this as dry contacts, not as 12 volt active. And so that's just gone back to my hub mini that I showed you across those. When those two, the circuit is completed, that's when the door actually opens. So that really is the core of those bits.
So I do want to just show you now what it looks like in your Unifi Access app. Again, on my mobile, you see my door position shows that if the circuit is closed, then it believes my door is in the closed position. Exit, you can see by standard, is normally open, and therefore if the circuit is closed, it should do an action. So let's just go to the front and have a look. And you'll actually see it shows as unauthorized open. That means that my circuit for my door position is actually closed, and it believes now that it's been there longer than my timeout, which was about 1 second. If you remember, I set that earlier. And so it's warning me that the door, it believes, has been left open. If I push the door back to set it to a lock, in my instance, it says open, but it's obviously closing the roller shutter. Once that roller shutter comes back down again, that circuit is going to be opened. And as a result, the door warning system here will tell me essentially that the door has been closed. So you can see now it says locked and the circuit has been broken. And as a result, now the door is in the closed position. Hopefully that helps a little bit more. So hopefully, although that was a bit rough and ready, showed you what you could actually achieve just using the Hub Mini. So you do obviously remember have dry or active. Active is actually going to provide power, and generally going to use that if you've got probably a lock like this. A gate or a door, garage door opener that I've got has already got power, and all it needs is a completing of the circuit. So we're going to change this to dry, and you can see that it can work. And then maybe you can put something like this on the wall if you don't want to have to use the app inside, and that will again have the same action. So although it might say exit, when I push that button, it will start the motor. When I push it again, it will stop the motor and potentially reverse the garage door, depending on how your garage door has been set up. So hopefully that has been useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more deep dives, and hopefully they'll be useful for you. Subscribe and stay up to date.